Hello everyone, it's fantastic to have you back. Today, I will demonstrate how to configure automatic numbering for P&ID components using both project data and drawing data in AutoCAD Plant 3D. Let's begin. First, let's go through the process of setting up Autonumbering for P&IDs using project data. Begin by opening Project Setup and navigating to P&ID DWG Settings, P&ID Class Definitions, Engineering Items, Lines, Pipeline Segments. Choose the existing tag format and click the Modify button. Ensure that your tag format includes the Pipeline Group .line number property. Locate the Pipeline Group line number property and click the Define Expression button, which is the fourth button from the left. If the option No Expression Freestyle Value is checked, uncheck it. Then, check the Auto Generate Expression option. Select Project Field and click the small icon below to open the Project Auto Generation Property dialog. In the Project Auto Generation Property dialog, click the new button and enter last line number as the name and description to set auto numbering for pipelines. Here, you can input the last used value and increment value. The last used value indicates where the numbering series will start, while the increment determines how much the number will increase with each new component. Click OK, select the last line number row, and click OK again. Then, confirm by clicking OK on the Define Expression dialog box and the Tag Format Setup dialog box. Repeat these steps to set up auto numbering for other P&ID class definitions, such as equipment, hand valves, general instrument symbols, inline instruments, etc. For any P&ID class definitions that do not have a default auto generation property, you will need to create a new one. We previously created last line number, so follow the same steps to establish additional auto generation properties as needed, such as last loop number for instruments, last tank number for tanks, and last inline instruments number for inline instruments. Note: you can also create your own custom names if desired. Finally, click OK to save your settings and exit Project Setup. To set up auto numbering for P&IDs using drawing data, the remaining steps are same to those we followed for configuring auto numbering for P&IDs using project data. Only you need to select drawing field instead of project field in the auto generate expression option and click the small drawing file icon below to open the Drawing Auto Generation Property dialog. In the Drawing Auto Generation Property dialog, choose the last line number row, which should be available by default, and click OK. Click OK again in the Define Expression dialog box, and then click OK in the Tag Format Setup dialog box. Finally, click OK to save your settings and exit Project Setup. You can repeat these steps to set up auto numbering for other P&ID class definitions, such as equipment, hand valves, general instrument symbols, and inline instruments. For drawing-based auto numbering, you need to specify the AutoGen properties for each individual drawing file. To do so, open the project in the Project Manager. Select the desired P&ID file, right-click, and choose the Drawing AutoGen Properties option from the context menu. Here, you can enter the last used value and increment value. If you need to reset the last used value to zero after deleting line numbers or components in your drawing files, you can do so in the Drawing AutoGen Properties dialog box. The same process applies to project data autogen properties. Note: proceed at your own discretion. That's all for today's episode. If you found this guide helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Make sure to hit that bell icon so you never miss an update on latest videos. Thank you for watching and see you next time.